Happy New Year's, beautiful. I'm here at a little bit of a gym cool down. Workout's over. I just need a place to catch my breath and talk to you for a minute. So, as you know, I'm sure by now, it's probably January 1st, maybe January 2nd where you are. Yeah, I did finish up at the gym, but I have no rah-rah gym motivation for you today. My goal, January mainly, is gonna be convince you to make a habit of making habits. So yeah, we're gonna get a little meta here. For those of you that have heard of this before, you know, continuous line progress, the X effect, no 0 days, it goes by different names. However, if in 2023, in 2022, in 2021, you had a hell of a time making and accomplishing goals, I can tell you it's probably not because you didn't aim high enough or you didn't pick the right goals. I'm going to tell you that it's likely because you did not establish the habit of habits. And here is what I mean by that. The areas of my life where I have made continuous progress are the ones where I just did the stupid, small, everyday, low-level grunt work. Just the simple stuff. Drinking, you know, water every hour. Standing and stretching every hour. Gym time. Everybody at the gym will hear will tell you it's Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. Sometimes I'm only in here for 10 minutes, but I want to step in the door. Whether it's, you know, it could be other stuff like cleaning your desk, making content if you want to be a big content creator, reading a book. I am not perfect at this, but what I can tell you is that if you are looking for a hack, a trick, something in 2024 to get to someplace, do the basics. Do the basics. Look at your calendar. I've talked about this before on many, many videos. Please go listen to the podcast, subscribe, obviously. Listen to YouTube, subscribe, obviously. But I've just made a habit of making habits. So here's what you can do for 2024. Don't buy any apps. Don't buy any new books. Just look at your calendar and make a series of repeating daily or weekly appointments of the things you want to do. And this can be really challenging for those of you that have, you know, full-time 40, 50, 60 hour a week job, because your day, your life is consumed with doing work for someone else. So it's hard to get in the habit of, you know, looking at a calendar or whatever and just putting repeating appointments on there. You know, it could be something as easy as every Monday from 6 to 6:15 you do this. Every Friday night from 7 to 9 you do this. That's one of the things that I really love about my calendar is if you were to look at my calendar, I will gladly share it with you. It's a series of repeating appointments. Once you do that, everybody else has to schedule things around you, which gets into my whole philosophy of schedule your first. You've always heard of like the way to get wealthy or the way to hit a savings goal is to pay yourself first. Well, it comes true with your time management also. Pay yourself first when it comes to managing your time. Your boss is gonna say, this needs to be done by yada, yada, yada. But you know what? Your boss doesn't have to help you lose weight. Your boss doesn't have to help you make money. Your boss is there to please himself and to please the company and to please his superiors. So they're going to make their priorities first, and your priorities are not the same as your priorities. So regardless of job, regardless of spouse, regardless of your dating situation, regardless of your health, you have to prioritize your things first. So out of one thing from this video, I want you to do this. Pull up a calendar, and if you don't live and die by a calendar, start. Go to Google, go to gmail.com and get yourself a Google account and set up a calendar and connect it to your phone. One thing from this video, put a single repeating appointment on your calendar and then comment below with the appointment you did. I'm gonna post this video on YouTube, on Facebook, on the podcast. Like I said, please make sure you subscribe, but that's all I want you to do now. Comment with the one new repeating habit you put on your calendar. You know what? You got more coming. Like I said, make sure you subscribe, and I'll see you during the next video. Let's get these habits going. Ooh, boy, I stink. Time to go home and put on some underarm deodorant.